Very good morning, dear students. I am Khushi Malviya, Professor SIPTec College, Gandhinagar. Today we are going to start the topic from the subject Herbal Drug Technology. And we are going for today's class, we have selected the topic Indian System of Medicine, that is from Unit 1st. So we are going to start now. Indian System of Medicine. In introduction, we will study about the traditional system of medicines. As we know that traditional system of medicine plays an important role in primary healthcare needs. We all know that traditional system is very oldest system of our Indian medicine. The system of medicine which are of Indian origin or which have come to India from outside and got incorporated into Indian culture are known as the Indian system of medicines. And as India has a rich heritage of traditional medicines and traditional healthcare system, traditional healthcare system, in all traditional medicines, the medicinal plants play a very important role in treating any diseases. As Indian traditional medicine is based on different system of medicines, like which include, you all know that, like Ayurveda, Siddha, Yunani, Yoga and Naturopathy and Homeopathy. Apart from these system, there are large number of healers which have not been placed in any category. Like if you talk about majority of Indian traditional medicine is based on three different systems, that is Ayurveda, Siddha, Yunani and Homeopathy. So the first thing that we are going to discuss is that is very important, that is Ayurveda. What is Ayurveda? Ayurvedic system of medicine is the oldest medical system. And what do you mean by Ayurveda? What is the Ayurveda word means? It is the Ayurveda word means the science of life. Okay, what is this? The science of life. And the if you talk about the concept of Ayurveda, when it was developed. So the Ayurveda concept was developed between 2500 and 500 BC, that is before the Christ in India. Okay. The word Ayurveda comprises of Ayur and Veda. Ayur means life and Veda means science. Okay. Now the next, if you talk about the Indian Hindu mythology. So what is that? The Indian Hindu mythology states four Vedas that was written by the Aryans, which forms the backbone of Indian civilization. जो कि आप लोगों ने सुना होगा फोर वेदास के बारे में, हिंदूज की ये चीजें बहुत ही ज्यादा इंपॉर्टेंट है हमारे लिए. वेद की बातें जब हम करते हैं, राइट, वो क्या है, हमारा जो इंडियन सिविलाइजेशन है एक उसका बैकबोन फॉर्म करता है हमारे ये फोर आयुर्वेदास जो आर्यंस के द्वारा लिखे गए थे. एंड व्हाट वाज दैट फोर वेदास? दैट फोर वेदास आर Rigveda, Samveda, Yajurveda and Atharveda. And Ayurveda is the part of the Atharveda. Okay, this was the about the Vedas. Now the next, we will talk about the Charaka Samhita. What is this Charaka Samhita? If you heard that the name, it was the first book having concept of practice of Ayurveda, that is it is for the school of medicine. Okay, and what was in that book? It describes 600 plants and their products used in medicine. Okay, this was about the Charaka Samhita and it was recorded in 1900 BC. This was the first book of Ayurveda. Then the next, Shushruta Samhita was the next Ayurvedic literature which aimed on surgery. Okay, That is for school of the surgery. And what was in that book? It deals with different theories and fundamental principles of surgery. It describes about 650 drugs, different surgery related topics like anatomy, toxicology, embryology, etc. It also describes the use of various surgical instruments like scissors, scalpels, forceps, etc. So in Sushruta Samhita, that was the Ayurvedic literature after the Chakra Samhita. So in this, everything related to the surgery concept was there in this, that book. Now we will come next to the basic principles of Ayurveda. So what was in that? In basic principles of Ayurveda, the basic principles of Ayurveda consist of many. First is Panch Bhutas, then second is the B, that is three gunas, then three dosas, then the saptadhatus, then the three malas, then three yodhasa agni. First we will talk about the Panch Bhutas. What is this? According to the Ayurveda, the universe is made up of five basic elements, that is also known as Panch Bhutas. Jaisa hum sabhi jante hain, jo hamara bhumandal hai, wo kin panch tatvon se bana hai? आप सभी को पता है ये चीजें, फिर भी मैं आपको बताना चाहूंगी. अकॉर्डिंग टू आयुर्वेदा द यूनिवर्स इज मेड अप ऑफ बेसिक फाइव एलिमेंट्स, ऑल्सो नोन एज पंच भूतास, जिनको हम कहते हैं पंच भूतास, राइट? एंड व्हाट विल कम इन दिस? फर्स्ट इट विल कम स्पेस, एयर, फायर, वाटर, अर्थ एटसेट्रा. व्हाट वी कॉल आकाशा, आकाशा मीन्स स्पेस, देन तेजा और अग्नि, इट मीन्स fire, then vayu, vayu means air, jala water, and prithvi is earth. Okay, all these are mixed in an infinite variety of relative proportions, such that each form of matter is distinctly unique. Okay, then by constant change or interacting with each other, they create a situation which keeps the world going on. Okay, first we will talk about the akasa. Akas means space. What is this? It corresponds to spaces within the body like mouth, nostrils, abdomen, etc. The next, vayu. It denotes the movement, okay, like muscular, also nervous system. Then the next, agni. Agni regulates the functioning of enzymes, intelligence, digestive system, and metabolism. Next is jala, jal. It denotes all body fluids as plasma, saliva, digestive juices, etc. Then the last, prithvi. Prithvi means the solid structure of the body, like bones, teeth, flesh, air, all this. Okay, this is prithvi. So, Panch Mahabhuta serves the basis of all diagnosis and treatment. Okay, and in Ayurveda, and is the most valuable theory for the physicians to detect and to treat illness of the body and the mind. So, now you got it how the Panch Bhutas plays a very important role in diagnosis and treatment in the Ayurveda, how it correlates. Got it, students? So it's a very important to know about the Panch Bhutas if you are studying the Ayurveda system. And the next, just I told you about the three gunas, three doshas, saptadhatus, three malas, three dosa agnis. Three gunas having three gunas like sattva, rajas, and tamas. The three sattva, these are the three essential components of the mind. Okay, gunas. We are talking about the gunas, three gunas. Ayurveda describes people on the basis of their manasa. That manas means physiological and prakriti, that is constitution. These physiological characters depend on the amount of these three gunas which we have talked about, sattva, rajas and tamas. The three gunas when present in proper proportion maintain healthy state of the mind, and any disturbance in this equilibrium result in mental disorder. Okay students, this is all about the today's class. Now the further we will continue in the next class. Thank you, have a nice day.